everybody. This is Dr. Linda Plank. I'm one of the associate deans at the nursing school, and I am so glad that we're able to talk today about you becoming one of our Baylor nursing students. So I just want to let you know that you've made two very good decisions so far. One is to come to Baylor, and the other is to be a nurse. I made those same two decisions way back over 40 years ago, and I have never regretted either one of them. You'll be very proud of your Baylor career. You'll be very proud of your nursing career. A little bit about our school is you'll be joining 1,100 nursing students, some in the Army getting their CRNA degree, others that are across the nation getting their doctorate of nursing practice in almost every state in the United States. Many across the state of Texas in our distance ABSN program. That's our accelerated one-year program that just starts this August. But you are joining a big group of Baylor nurses that have a great reputation, not just here in Texas, but throughout the United States. So we're so glad that you can join us, and we'll be very happy when we can see you in person. But in the meantime, sick 'em bears.
Good morning. My name is Dr. Renee Flippo, and I'm faculty at the Louise Harrington School of Nursing at Baylor University. I've been asked to do this video to just give you a little highlight of why I chose to come to Baylor and what is great about being a Baylor Louise Harrington School of Nursing student. So 5 years ago, we chose to move to Dallas, and when we were making that move, I was already teaching in a secular school of nursing. But in Baylor, when we chose to come to Texas, because we didn't live in Texas at the time, Baylor was the one place where I applied. Number one, the reputation it has for excelling in education and the rigor that it applies for its education, and already had a national reputation. And so I did not live in Texas. I lived in a different state, but yet I knew of that reputation. And then also the faith-based component. As someone who's been a nurse for 26 years and who literally can be the hands and feet of Christ in my profession, I wanted to come to an institution where I could incorporate my faith along with educating students. And again, you don't have to be a nurse to be the hands and feet of Christ. You can be in a different profession at Baylor and choose to graduate with a different degree and still be those hands and feet of Christ. You can do that as a lawyer. You can do that as an accountant. Whatever career you choose, you can absolutely serve as the hands and feet of Christ. And then one thing that I love about teaching Louise Harrington School of Nursing students is they're phenomenal. Again, as I stated before, I came from a secular institution and my students were great. I had great students, but the students at Baylor are just phenomenal. They are compassionate. They are diligent. They pursue excellence in their education like I've never seen before. And that just makes it all the more fun to come to work every day. What does a day in the life of a level one, which is a first semester nursing student, look like? So you have three classes the first 5 weeks of the semester. So you're going to have your health assessment class, you're going to have your foundations of nursing class, and you're going to have your introduction to professional nursing practice class. So you'll be in class for two of those. One of those is online. The foundations of nursing class is the one that's online, and it's where we teach you the nursing process. It's where we teach you the history of nursing, the philosophy of nursing, as well as nursing theory, because nursing is a profession. It's its own profession. So it has all those elements of being a profession. We also teach you about research in nursing, because research is so critical to moving forward the knowledge and education that we have in order to better care for our patients. Then in health assessment, you're going to learn how to do a head-to-toe assessment, all the body areas that you need to address, what's normal and what's abnormal for each of those body systems. And then your introduction to professional nursing practice, you're going to learn about the nursing skills that you'll be using in the clinical setting. So for example, giving medications, as far as orally, inhalations, injections, all those things you're going to learn in your introduction to professional nursing practice class. Along with the classes, you'll also be in lab for several hours a week during those first 5 weeks. So you're going to be in a health assessment lab as well as a PMP or Introduction to Professional Nursing Practice lab. So you'll be taking those things you learn in class and then applying them to the lab setting to hone those skills and refine those skills before doing them in the hospital setting. After you take those three classes the first 5 weeks, you're going to take all that knowledge, because in nursing, the classes build on one another. So you take the knowledge you've obtained from one class to move to another. And you're going to take that knowledge you have from the lab and the class settings, and then you're going to apply it to the clinical setting. So you'll go into clinical the second half of the semester while you're actually be in the hospital setting, and you'll apply all that knowledge to actual patients that you're seeing. You'll not be on your own in the hospital setting. You will be paired with a clinical faculty who's experienced and who will guide you along the way. Then during the last half of the semester, you'll be also taking your first Patho-Pharm 1 class and then your Human Needs 1 class at the same time. So lab and class the first 5 weeks, clinical and class the rest of the semester. And the reason why we chose to do it that way is so you feel comfortable having that foundation when you step in for the first time into a patient's room. There's still going to be a little nerves, but you will have that clinical faculty to guide you as well as the knowledge you've already obtained. And so that's kind of how the first semester is set up for you guys. And it will give you the opportunity to serve those patients. One thing we have to remember is, though, even though we're the hands and feet of Christ, that not everyone we serve has the same faith-based foundation that we come from. And that's one thing you'll learn in your classes, is to care for people who may not have the same faith that we do and still be able to be the hands and feet of Christ to those individuals. And that's one thing I tell my students, and that's one approach that we see differently at the Louise Harrington School of Nursing, is the holistic person, the spirituality of that person, looking at them from a whole perspective, not just from a medical model, but from the whole perspective of a human being, our emotions, our mental status, our physical status, all of these things you'll be learning how to care for. And I tell my students, I tell them, you have the opportunity to be there when it's somebody's worst day as well as somebody's best day. So on the opposite extremes, because I've been there in my nursing career. I've been there when it was a parent's worst day, when they lost their child, and I've been there when it was their best day, when the child recovered and they were able to go home. So that's our approach that we take at the Louise Harrington School of Nursing. One thing that's also unique about the Louise Harrington School of Nursing is our ability to serve, not only to serve in the hospital setting, but in the community and globally as well. So as nursing faculty, one of the ways I get to serve, and I love this, is we have partnered with the Dallas Independent School Districts, and I have been able to teach their brand new school nurses. So nurses that have maybe been nurses for a while, but are brand new to school nursing, who maybe worked in the hospital setting, but now have chosen to work in the schools. I have been able to teach them how to do a good pediatric physical assessment. They're in those schools alone, making those decisions alone, seeing those kids without another person to consult. So what's normal? What's abnormal? What's a red flag? When can they send those kids home with the parents? When do they need to call their supervisor? When do they need to get emergency medical treatment for that child? So again, our outreaches, the ability to serve others, not only again in the hospital, but those around us in the Dallas area, as well as globally. And that's one another thing that's unique in Dallas, is our abilities to utilize so many of the facilities here We have numerous hospitals within the DFW area. Our students go to many of those hospitals, and it gives the ability to see how different facilities work. So I hope this has been helpful for you. I hope it's given you a little bit of insight of what it might look like to be a nursing student at the Louise Harrington School of Nursing for Baylor University. And hope you guys have a great day. Thanks.
My name is Dr. Shelby Garner, and I'm an associate professor at the Baylor University Louise Harrington School of Nursing. I came to Baylor because I was interested in teaching at a school that values high academic standards in a Christian environment, and that's exactly what I found at Baylor. There are many universities that promote a Christian environment, but I found at Baylor they don't just promote it, they actually walk the walk. I knew Baylor was the place for me when they prayed with me during my interview. My very favorite part of teaching at Baylor is the students. We have such a diverse student body, and I love getting to know the students personally. I teach research and servant leadership, and these courses give me the freedom to collaborate with students one-on-one and in small groups to conduct hands-on nursing research and service projects. Many of these projects are global projects. My research focuses on building nursing knowledge and resources in India. And every year, it's an honor and honestly so much fun to take Baylor nursing students to India with me on mission, service, and research trips. It's truly one of the great passions of my life. There, we work together with amazing nurses and physicians in India on a variety of projects serving disadvantaged populations in rural villages and urban impoverished areas. It's really hard work, but students often return from these trips changed with a new perspective on nursing and life in general. And we don't just offer these experiences in India. We offer nursing student experiences on a local level in homeless shelters in Dallas. We serve immigrants on the Texas border, and our mission and study abroad trips are offered in Africa, Europe, South America, and various parts of Asia. These types of experiences, whether they be local or global, are instrumental in preparing students to become nurses. If you choose our School of Nursing, you will be given a multitude of opportunities to help you decide exactly what kind of nurse you want to be. I've had students that have gone on to serve as foreign missionaries or locally in ICUs, ERs, neonatal intensive care units, labor and delivery units, and many, many other places. Really, the sky is the limit. Many of our students go on to further their education, becoming nurse anesthetists, nurse practitioners, research nurses, and educators. A Baylor nurse is known as an outstanding nurse, and your education at Baylor will be valued by others. Receiving this education in a Christian and mission-focused environment is another unique way that Baylor stands apart from other universities. My own daughter is now a student at Baylor, and it's been such a joy to experience Baylor through her eyes. She didn't know anyone at Baylor as an incoming freshman, and she went on an international mission trip as part of her line camp experience. She met so many like-minded friends on that trip, and after 2 years, she still has a tight-knit of group friends that emerged through the mutual service they performed together, and they're a huge support to each other. I'll leave you with my favorite verses of Scripture. Romans 12:1 says, "For us to offer our bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God, it is our true and proper worship." This means that every single thing that we do is a form of worship. The work we do, the way we study, and the environment we study in. Romans 12:2 says, "Do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you can test and approve what God's will is, his good, pleasing, and perfect will." And so I hope you will consider Baylor and the Louise Harrington School of Nursing as your university and school of choice. I promise that if you do, you are in store for a transformational educational experience in a Christian environment that will prepare you to be an outstanding and professional registered nurse. Thank you.